Hey everyone, मेरा नाम है नोवा ब्लास्ट एंड आई एम बैक विथ अनदर वीडियो. और इस बार हम बात करने वाले हैं एवेंजर्स एंड गेम के ट्रेलर के बारे में. आई नो कि वन पंच मैन वॉज शेड्यूल फॉर द वीक, बट उसको थोड़ा पुश बैक करना पड़ेगा. सो ज़्यादा टीपी ना करते हुए लेट्स गो राइट इन टू द वीडियो. सो मैंने एक चीज़ देखी है इस ट्रेलर में कि मार्वल इज ट्राइंग टू कनेक्ट ऑल द डॉट्स इन दिस ट्रेलर बिकॉज इट इज़ शोइंग द सिग्निफिकेंस कि वो कितना टाइम हो चुका है as they've started this journey, 20 years, and they're finally connecting all the dots because there are very similar things happening right now. As Tony is speaking ki main wo cave ke bahar aaya and now he's in a similar situation, stuck in the spaceship, he's drifting away, he's trying to find a way out, I would hope, but it does not just stop there. In the next shot, you can see the voiceover of Peggy Carter for Captain America's past. You can see the eclipse from the first Avenger, and you can later see that Hawkeye is actually training somebody. Maybe it's his daughter. People are saying it's Kate Bishop, but I really don't think who was supposedly the new Hawkeye. And uske baad you can immediately see ki Hawkeye has turned rogue and now he is Ronin. Assuming ki uski puri family ja chuki hai, he's gone on a little darker path than usual. Peggy also says that it is better to start over. But that is like a nod to how they are planning to start everything over with the whole time travel stuff. It's just a theory jo kaafi log backup kar rahe hain. It could happen because of the whole quantum realm and we'll figure out when we see the movie. Uske baad you see the whole Asgard wala portion from the first Thor movie and you can see those little portions they are connecting from all the origin movies of these three main characters, as you can say. Thor shayad baki Avengers se baat kar raha hai when he says ki I saw all that people die, and uske baad you see Steve Rogers say ki I tell people to move on but I don't, or we don't, as they are planning to fix everything. You can also see ki Black Widow's hair has started to grow back to red, so that actually shows ki it's been some time, so I guess that would be somewhere around 6 months or something for her hair to grow back. Then you can see ki Ant-Man has returned to the normal world as he was stuck in the quantum realm jo humne Ant-Man and the Wasp ke end mein dekha tha, because uska pura squad is pretty much dead. He is at a surprise and he can see all those missing posters, and probably usko life ka sabse bada chhatka lag chuka hai abhi. You can also probably see the new Quinjet which they are going to travel in throughout the movie. Then you have the shot of Hawkeye running through a tunnel of sorts where an explosion has happened. Maybe somebody is attacking him, maybe he did the explosion himself, because you see a later shot where he pulls out the arrow towards something. So maybe something has gone wrong on his separate mission. It could be anything else. You can also see the classic suit of Rocket Raccoon and the new suit of War Machine. There are a little few tweaks in War Machine suit, but I don't think it's the same suit as the previous versions. As you can see, you can also see Thor full of lightning. I don't think wo is portion mein lad raha hai kisi se ya something. Maybe he's just charging up for something, maybe opening the Bifrost. And you can also see Nebula fighting somebody, and I guess that would be Thanos, because that amount of anger in Nebula comes when she sees Thanos. And I think this is more or less the third act of the movie. So according to me, the first act would be the getting everybody together, basically getting Tony and everything. The second part would be the whole quantum realm arc. And then the third part would be the final battle, just may everything seems a bit destroyed, honestly. And people are speculating this is not on Earth, but I think all this battle is going on Earth because of a later shot where Ant-Man is jumping over the pencil for some reason. You can also see Captain America strapping up his shield. It's a longer shot from the big game TV spot. And I think that is also near the final part of the movie, the third act. Aur iske baad aata hai, I guess, the most hype moment, jisme you can see almost everybody from the survivors. The people which you can't see is Hulk, you cannot see Captain Marvel, you cannot see Thor, and for some reason you can't see Rocket Raccoon, but you can see from the previous trailer he is there, probably below the camera or something. But the question is, where are the other guys? So I think Bruce Banner is still there because he might be in his Professor Hulk, as we saw in the teaser images. But I think the CGI is not yet done, so probably उन लोग ने trailer में नहीं डाला है. And as we know right now कि वो लोग trailer में बहुत झोल करते हैं, so it is not necessary कि everything we see is actually what is happening. And Tony and Nebula are back on Earth, and everybody is in their quantum realm suits, maybe going for a time travel, because I think it's a time travel movie, as everybody suggests, because Reddit pe there is a huge conversation going on ki trying to break down this trailer, and there are many theories, so it could be anything. And then one of the most badass scenes of the trailer, in which Thor or Captain Marvel ek dusre ko milte hain, in which Thor is being a little intimidated, but Captain Marvel does not give a you know what. So what are your thoughts on the trailer? It is good, bad? Did they show more? Did they show less? I think it is enough, and I think isse zyada theory mein ghuske fayda nahi hai. The movie is right around the corner, and if you like this trailer breakdown, please let me know. You can comment, subscribe, like it, you know the drill, and share it if you want to, because I might need that help. Growing my channel is hard, but nothing else. This is Noah, blasting off.